HTC's first new handset of 2016 is finally here, the HTC 10, boasting a new laser focus camera, a unique Android experience called Freestyle, and a lot of upgraded specs compared to last year's One M9. So, is it any good? Here's our full review. For this year's flagship, HTC has tweaked some important design elements while keeping several of the One brand's distinctive characteristics. So once again, we have a metal unibody, which blends neatly into that front glass panel. But this time, the usual curves are replaced with some chamfered edges, which feel comfortable in the palm and give the HTC 10 some funky styling, as well as the usual reassuring ruggedness. There's also a glorious return for that physical home back and menu buttons housed just beneath the screen. To keep up with rival flagships, HTC has kitted out the HTC 10 with a 5.2-inch Quad HD display, and it's a seriously strong panel. You might not get the same funky curved edges as the Galaxy S7, but images are crisp and viewing angles are strong, as is the maximum brightness. Best of all, you get full manual control over the color gamut and the warmth in HTC's display settings, so you can tweak the display to match your mood. One of my favorite HTC features was always the boom sound speakers, mostly because the name is just so fun to say. Boom sound! At first glance, oh no, the HTC 10 appears to do away with that stereo speaker setup. But thankfully, that is not the case. The bottom speaker has merely shifted from just beneath the screen to the base of the phone, and these mobile blows are as powerful as ever. You get an impressively weighty sound on top volume with no crackle or distortion. And of course, the HTC 10's support for high-res audio means that music fans will be in heaven. For its latest flagship, HTC wisely decided to work closely with Google to produce a more efficient user experience. That makes for a streamlined version of Marshmallow, topped with a couple of notable HTC features. One of these is of course the Blink Feed desktop for checking out the latest headlines and your social media stirrings, and it's easily dispensed with if you don't want it. However, the HTC 10's most intriguing addition is the new Freestyle desktop feature, which we've quickly come to adore. This does away with Android's traditional grid layout and allows you to scatter your shortcuts and widgets all over the bloody place, complete with a choice of bonkers themes. It works surprisingly well and it really does make for a truly unique experience. Check out our full Freestyle desktops feature over at recombi.com/mobile for our full thoughts and info. One of the reasons that we now have a physical home button beneath the HTC 10 screen is that it doubles as a fingerprint sensor, something that we've pretty much come to expect from modern flagship phones. Impressively, that scanner is probably the best that we've used. Not a bad effort considering HTC's previous flagships didn't actually have one. Once you've registered your prints, you can basically press your chosen finger or thumb to the sensor at any angle, and it'll almost certainly be recognized first time. The unlock time is blisteringly fast too, at around half a second tops. Speaking of fast, the HTC 10 is powered by Qualcomm's Snapdragon 820 chipset, which gives a super smooth all-round experience. I haven't witnessed a single crash or stutter while the latest games play with dependable frame rates. As for battery life, the HTC 10 is more than a match for the S7 and LG's G5. You can comfortably make it through a full day on one charge, even with plenty of camera use and music streaming. And if you want to stream video non-stop over Wi-Fi, you can still expect around 8 hours of life, one of the better results that we've seen recently. You also get support for Quick Charge 3.0, which means that you can charge the phone's 3000mAh battery to full capacity in around an hour and a quarter. Or you can grab yourself enough power to last that commute with just about 5 or 10 minutes of the plug. The HTC 10 aims to right the wrongs of previous HTC flagships with a fresh new 12-megapixel snapper, bolstered by a laser-guided autofocus. We fully tested and reviewed that 12-megapixel rear snapper and the 5-megapixel selfie camera as well, and put them up against the brilliant Galaxy S7 optics, so check out our full HTC 10 camera review for more info. The HTC 10 is a solid all-round package, a phone that has very few weaknesses and certainly doesn't disappoint like last year's One M9. Media fans will love the gorgeous screen, those boom sound speakers, and the high-res audio support, while the funky Freestyle desktops give Android a fresh new look and feel that's definitely overdue. Sadly, the camera tech isn't quite as strong as some of its rivals, and there is a bit of a lack of sex appeal, something that the Galaxy S7 and the S7 Edge had in spades. But if you're more about rugged metal than gorgeous glass, the HTC 10 is reassuringly solid and scratch resistant. For a full HTC 10 review and tons more content, check out recombi.com/mobile, and don't forget to subscribe to the Recombi YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.